All right, well, today I'm not putting my attention on the box that I've been doing yesterday and previous days. I showed this in the last video, and I'm going to kind of leave it as is for right now. I'm going to show you something else here in just a second. Right now what I'm working on is I want to clean off these cab corners, like that one over the that one right there, and the same over on the other side. Get that all cleaned off, all that white paint on there that I just had to protect the bare metal from rusting. I'm getting all that off. Might have a little sand or sanding, grinding, whatever you want to call it, on the weld. And then I'm going to be applying the Rage Gold. This is the body filler that I've been using. I don't know if I've shown you that or not. That's what I've been using. Love it. It works really good. And I did a lot of research on it before I got it, so I knew it would. It's supposed to be, you know, one of the better body fillers, I believe. And I will tell you, when I did that other box that I sold last spring, the body filler that I used on that was... It's that stuff back there, which is much cheaper. It's only like, I think, I don't know, 25, 30 bucks a gallon. Sands like a rock. It sands hard compared to this. This stuff really sands really nice. So that's what I am using. And I just happen to have another gallon of this stuff sitting over there just in case. It's not cheap. It is a little more expensive. I believe on that one I paid $85 for that gallon, and that one over there I paid about $70. If you think ahead a little bit, you can go on Amazon or other places online, and I think I've seen it as low as like $45. Of course, then you have shipping on top of that, so who knows for sure, but you can get it cheaper. Almost everything you're going to use, you can get cheaper if you look around for it online. You can save yourself a lot of money. Anyway, that's what I'm getting at now, and I'm off to a late start today. It's almost 4 o'clock, and just didn't get going this morning. Daughter had a soccer game, and then we went to McDonald's, and then we came home, and then I had to run over and got me a bunch more paint cups. Paint cups, stirring sticks. I got the same Omni I did. I got another quart of the Omni. Same stuff I used under the hood and the clear back there. And then I discovered that I have this quart here that I used under the hood. And I'm thinking there's probably enough in there to do that. Inside of that door. I'm not sure. It's going to be real close. And I wouldn't want to get started and run out anyway, so I had to buy it. I was going to just use part of the gallon that I got for doing the truck, but which is probably way, way, way more than I'll need. But the last thing I want to do on my first paint job is to run out of frickin' paint, you know, in the middle of painting. That would not be good. And then I got this goof off and this other oops stuff here. This is just stuff we had in the house. I've been told this stuff is supposed to be really good for taking off, like the adhesive that's underneath that white and chrome strip on the door. Remember what it left on the box. I guess it's supposed to take that stuff off. I don't know how, because that the wheel on that there drill sure wouldn't take it off. And I ended up sanding it off for the most part. But hey, I'm going to give it a shot. But right now, I'm focusing on these cab corners. I want to get these cab corners done, which won't take too much. And get those done. These white spots on the fender had a couple little tiny rust places on them, which I welded up shut. And they probably need a little more attention, and then some body filler on those. The hood, and I knew this when I got it. Well, actually, I didn't know it until I got it home. But it's got a let's see, yeah, right there, it's got a spot. Sand that down, get it smooth. I don't think there's a dent there, but I'm gonna put some filler over that anyway and get this down the middle. It's just got, almost get it off my finger probably, real light surface rust. Other than that, the hood's in good shape. And then I need to get that door off, and I need to get the inside of that door sprayed. And probably, not sure what I'm gonna do on the outside of that door. It does have some rock chips in the paint and so forth, so I may just take it down to metal. And I've got some epoxy primer, or I've got the high build that I've been using. It's a direct to metal high build. If I want to use that or not, I could use the black like I did on this side of the box. So that, I mean, that would, if anything, help match, since I already use it on this side anyway. I'll figure that out as I go. But anyway, right now I'm going to get to work on these cab corners, and I will bring you back in when I have made some progress. Sorry about that, I just turned you off and I'm gonna turn you back on. But something else I got was this tube of, it's by USC. Sorry, I didn't even have it on the camera. Auto body icing. Basically it's glazing putty. I guess they call it finishing putty, glazing putty. And I got that because I'm having some trouble with some, and I don't know if you can even see them on the camera, but I know there's one on the other side. Anyway, it's some sand scratches that I can't get them out. They're not wanting to come out very good. It'd also be good for where that damn bug landed in my paint, possibly. And I can't see anything else off the top of my head, but any place where it's showing through, whether I didn't get it sanded down good enough before, there's a little bit of a, oh, I know where there's one. I don't know if you'll be able to see it right there. Actually it fills in pretty nice. More high build primer is probably going to cover that up, because that's only got like one shot on it. Anyway, what it's for is just a skim coat to help smooth everything out. And so I got that. I believe it was like $40, but if it's gonna help, it's worth it. So anyway, I thought I'd show you that. It's by USC. It's called just icing polyester finishing putty number 26006, if you're interested. And I'll let you know how it works as I use it. It's a two-part, comes with the hardener just like body filler, just like body filler. So anyway, supposed to dry in 15 minutes. You can sand it and then top coat it from there, but probably let it sit a little longer than that. It's not like I'm in a big hurry. So anywho, now I'll let you go and bring you back when there's something to show. Well, we're making a little progress. Things always take longer than you expect, but cab corners are getting there. You're gonna find out when you put on body filler, it's ugly. Especially the first couple of coats. This is the second coat, and it's, didn't do a real good job. But anyway, the front fender's pretty smooth. Got it done up there, and then these cab corners back here kind of glopped up right now, but they'll get smoothed out, and I'm not extremely worried about them. As long as the sides look okay, that's all I'm really worried about. I'm trying to get this backside here, straight as I can, but that's not what I'm, just not real critical. You'll see what I mean when I get it all put together, but it's coming along, and that's about all I got going on right now. So I'm gonna go up to the house, get something to eat, and then come back down and sand this down and go from there. Not sure what I'll do. Maybe shoot some primer on that would probably be a good thing once I get them smoothed out in those spots. But got a lot to do yet. I'm not so sure I'm gonna be ready to paint next weekend. It's just the way things go, but I'm gonna try. I'll bring you back in after a while.